Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. Hi, welcome to my little corner of the internet. My name is Abby, I'm 20 and I'm a university student from England. I love making content here on YouTube and I'm passionate about helping you on your journey of self-growth, as well as helping you in your relationship with God. I make lifestyle videos on how you can do this through small ways in your day-to-day lives, as well as videos about my faith journey in hopes that it inspires you in yours. If that sounds like something you want to see, then make sure that you are subscribed to my channel and click the bell so you don't miss any videos. I upload a new video every Sunday at 4 p.m. So this week I'm going to be talking about habits. How to build good habits that last and help you grow as a person. I'm going to be sharing with you guys some tips that I've learned along my ongoing journey of habit building and things that have actually helped me. None of that wishy-washy advice, just the good stuff that actually works. Now, I recently read this book right here, which is Atomic Habits by James Clear. And if you haven't read this book yet, I seriously recommend you read it after you watch this video because it is such a game changer and will help you so much along your journey of habit building. This book is a big reason why I'm filming this video, and a lot of tips I'm going to be sharing are things that I did get from this book and things that have actually helped me in my journey of habit building, and I know that they will help you in yours as well. So let's just get into the video. So the first thing we should probably establish is, what is a habit? A habit is a routine or practice performed regularly and is sometimes an automatic response. For example, you may have gotten into the habit of checking your phone or scrolling through social media when you wake up every morning. Habits can be positive and productive, and they can be bad and unproductive. A productive, positive habit would be like getting up in the morning as soon as your alarm goes off, as opposed to snoozing your alarm, going back to sleep, or scrolling aimlessly on your phone on social media. So now you know what a habit is, it's important for you to understand the habits that you already have. So take some time to observe your current habits. It's important to remember that habits can be good and bad. They can both work for you and against you. Something I found super helpful is to take a step back and observe my current day-to-day habits. Follow yourself through the day and just notice what you do. When you look at your phone, when you put the TV on, when you find something else to distract yourself with other than doing those hard things that are on your to-do list. From this, you can figure out what habits serve you and are productive to your day-to-day life, and also the ones that don't serve you and aren't productive for your day-to-day life as well. For me, I realised that I was checking my phone first thing every morning, which resulted in me aimlessly scrolling through Instagram for ages, and I realised that this just didn't set myself up for the best day ahead. And similarly, I found that doing the same habit before I went to sleep every evening negatively affected my ability to fall asleep and the quality of my sleep as well. But when I didn't go on my phone first thing in the morning at last thing at night, I felt more positive heading into my day and I felt like I had a better night's sleep for it. So firstly, ask yourself, what are my current habits and are they serving me or doing me a disservice? The next thing that is so important is focusing on who you want to be as opposed to what you want to achieve. It's easy to say, I want to wake up at 7 o'clock every morning, I want to run 3 times a week, or I want to read 2 chapters of my book every day, because believe me, I was there. But that mentality of having things you want to achieve can be kind of counterproductive in a way. They are not sustainable because they don't go deep into the core of who you are as a person. Instead, I found it really helpful to change my mindset into thinking about who I want to become as opposed to what I want to do or achieve. So instead of saying, I want to wake up at 7 o'clock every morning and not snooze my alarm, I said, I want to become a morning person who gets up when her alarm goes off and gets on with her day. Instead of saying, I want to run 3 times a week, I said, I want to become a runner. And it's kind of like having a lifestyle change in a way that comes from the core of who you are as opposed to something actionable or quantifiable. This is something that I noticed benefited me so much more even before I read this book, because James does mention it in this book, but I definitely could tell the difference when I started embracing that identity and started shifting my identity in a way that aligned with the lifestyle I wanted to have. It made it easier to form those positive habits. One of the things I love that James Clear says in Atomic Habits is this. He says, the real reason habits matter is not because they get you better results, but because they change your beliefs about yourself. So start thinking about who you want to become as opposed to what you want to do. The next thing that will make such a difference in making you build good habits is repetition. Repetition is so key. The more you do something, the easier and more automatic it becomes. The more you read your book before you pick up your phone in the morning, the easier it will be to pick up your book instead of your phone. And this goes for habits that are good and productive and habits that aren't necessarily good and are much more unproductive for you. So to build good habits, you need to get that repetition going. The next thing that is so important for getting good habits is sometimes you have to rewire your current habits. One of the most effective ways I found to build habits that are productive and last in my life is by rewiring my brain in a way, and this is something that you can do too. Lots of research in cognitive and biological psychology has shown this through the processes of operant conditioning and classical conditioning. And if you want to know a little bit more about that, then look up Skinner's theory of operant conditioning and his experiments with rats, and Pavlov's theory of classical conditioning and his experiments with dogs. From this, we know that all habits are built on a loop involving four steps: cue, craving, response, and reward. And these can be rewired through the four laws of behavior that James talks about in Atomic Habits, which I'm going to be sharing with you guys about in relation to how I built positive and sustainable habits, because it's honestly so helpful. So the first law is to make it obvious. So one way you can do this is through a habit stacking process, which I found the most helpful. For example, I've been getting into the practice of running more. So I would rewire my brain to say, after my morning routine, I will go on a run. Following one habit with another can be a great way to build momentum of positive habits, as I found once I started this, I just kept going. However, implementation intentions can also be helpful as well if you want to be more rigid and stricter with your habits. So I have been getting into the habit of using the downtime feature of my phone to basically lock all the apps on my phone and putting my phone away before I go to bed so that I can have an hour of no screens or social media before I go to bed and just read my book. So in this case, I basically rewired my brain to say, I will put my phone away and read my book at 10 p.m. every evening. So kind of having this behavior, time, and a location as well if you want, makes it as clear as possible so you can kind of structure your habits in a way that work well with your routine and the way you like it. The second law of behavior change is make it attractive. So combining the habit you need to do with an action you want to do can be really helpful for building habits, especially the ones that feel quite difficult to implement. For example, you naturally want to check your phone in the morning, but I won't let myself do it until I have first spent time with God, read my Bible, and prayed. So having those two things combined can really help cement those habits in your life. The main people you surround yourself with in life are the main people that will have the biggest impact on the way you live your life and the person you become. And the same can be said for the habits you build. So finding people who also share that same desired behavior can be really helpful for building your habits. For example, finding a friend to go to the gym with might help you become more of a gym person, as well as maybe joining a book club might help you become more of a reader. The third rule is make it easy. Shape your environment so that it makes it easy to do the habit that feels really hard. For example, if you want to go on a run or go to the gym in the morning, lay out your exercise clothes the night before so they are ready to go. I also found that this made it harder not to do it as well, because I knew that it was more effort to put those clothes away instead of putting them on and going and doing my exercise. Within this, you can also start small as well. So if you're finding it really hard to get a good habit going, then reduce the time it takes to do that habit into a few minutes. For example, if you're trying to become a reader, let yourself read for a few minutes and then make yourself stop, and you'll find yourself want to keep reading, and you'll find that desire in yourself to keep that habit going, and then it becomes easier to do that for a longer, more sustainable amount of time. And the final rule is make it satisfying. So you can do this by using a positive reinforcement, something immediately rewarding when you've completed your habit to motivate you. For example, when I've done a run, not only do I find the immediate satisfaction of knowing I've run for 30 minutes, I also get to reward myself with a post-run shower, which always feels amazing, especially when I get to wash my hair after it's gotten all sweaty. And that's just a way that I use positive reinforcement when I run, but you can do this in lots of other ways too. It also probably doesn't surprise you, but I absolutely love using habit trackers. I have found it so helpful and satisfying when building positive habits. It's just so satisfying to tick off a habit every day and keeping that streak going. Likewise, it can be really unsatisfying and disheartening to see it not ticked off and breaking a streak. So I think habit trackers are a good way to implement that satisfaction. The last thing I want to say on this is the journey won't always be straightforward. Building habits that last and are sustainable is not an upward cycle. It is okay if you fall out of track of your good habits or you fall back into bad ones. We are all human, but it's what you do when that happens that defines who you are and who you'll become. If I end up skipping a run, for example, it doesn't mean I'm not a runner anymore. It just means I've missed a run. Or if you've ended up snoozing your alarm one day, it doesn't mean you're not a morning person. It just means that you needed some extra few hours sleep. Don't let slipping up define you. Get yourself back on track, and sometimes that might involve going back down to the basics and to the core of who you are and going back through all those steps again and starting from the beginning, but it is so worth it. I have a new rule where I don't let myself skip a good habit more than once, so it stops me from getting into bad habits. So for example, if I miss a run one day, I make sure that the next day I'm scheduled to do a run, I don't miss it. Or if I snooze my alarm one morning, I make sure that the next day, when my alarm goes off, I don't snooze it. And this will really help you not get into a rut or into a pattern of bad habits. So these are a few things that I've learned along my journey of building good habits that last and are productive and serve me and the person that I'm becoming. I hope this has been helpful for you guys and your journey of habit building. These are just small ways that you can implement in your day-to-day lives to help you on your journey of self-growth. If you have enjoyed this video, make sure to give a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you are new and click the bell so you don't miss any of my future uploads. Like I said, I upload every Sunday at 4 p.m, so make sure you are subscribed. Also, go follow me on Instagram. I post frequently over there and I like to interact with you guys over there, so make sure you are following me there. Also, share this video with someone that you think might benefit them, maybe a friend, family member, and let me know your tips for habit building in the comments as well. Let us know what you've been doing, what you have found helpful. I hope you guys have a blessed week and never forget how loved you are, and I'll see you next week for a brand new video. Bye guys!